Hi everybody, this is Patty from A Soul's Heartbeat, and I wanted to come and show you this this kit before I end up cutting it up, and then I just have pieces to show you. I was contacted by Anton from Bontik Vintage Designs. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. He's an Etsy seller. Has wonderful designs. He wanted to know if I'd like to do a collaboration. He would gift me some designs and I could make something and give his Etsy shop a shout out. So of course. And the first thing that I saw was this little chapel kit. Now, if you're going to go over to his shop and purchase anything, he has graciously offered all of my viewers a 50% discount code. In the code area, you just have to put in my name, Patty, P-A-T-T-I. That will enable you to have a 50% off discount. Now, I saw this and instantly, you know, I make a lot of cards. Instantly, I thought sympathy cards. Sympathy cards are something I hate to make because of what you're using them for, and I need all the time, and my friends always need them. So I like to keep some on hand. I'm very, very short supply now. So when I saw these chapels, and when I grew up, I live in Southwest Washington State, and when I grew up, I went to Stella Lutheran Chapel, which is out in the woods, and it makes me think of these. I mean, it was just like, ah, look at this. These designs are absolutely beautiful. Now, let me go back here. You can get them in different sets, and I think there's four, or you can get the one that's all together, and this is the journal kit, and it has everything in it, which is 22 half pages. Which these are half pages because you've got two on a page. 22 double pages, 16 ATCs, 11 circles, 26 tags, 4 bookmarks, and 2 pockets. So let's just go through here, and I'll try not to take up too much of your time and ooh and ah. I just wanted, oh, look at this. Can you see the beautiful winter blues in this? Oh, and I love the background. Gorgeous. Look at this. Just, oh, they're just so appealing to me. I love, love, love them. Just love them. And I love the background images on all of these. Just, they are going to make wonderful cards. I've only made one, and it's so super simple. I'm almost embarrassed to show you, but I'll show you anyway. And then I'm going to go off for the next week or so and play and make some more. But look at these. Oh my goodness, look at this. It all looks like peeled paint is what it resembles, is what it makes me think of. And I know I have the camera kind of close, but I wanted you to be able to get the full effect of these because, oh, I think they're just gorgeous. And there's all kinds of things. I have another set that I'm going to be doing, and it's quirky animals, and it's about as far from these churches as you could get because it's wacky animals. And it's, again, it's going to be greeting cards. But so take a gander through his website or through his Etsy store because, oh my goodness, I think there are 500, if I remember, 500 and some kits. Packages that you can buy. Okay, now these I printed 2 to the page because I can't use the full page on them. It would just be a waste. But look at here. So pretty. I mean, are these just not? Now, what I'm thinking is I would like to make some sets of sympathy cards, and then I would like to make like a folder that folds open with a pocket, and a pocket that will hold maybe 6 cards or 4 cards in each side, and tie it so that I could gift them to some of my friends. That's what I'm thinking. So these would make, not these per se, the first ones I think would make, look at the blues in this, would make gorgeous folders for to house the cards. And look at the background, so neat. I don't know the backstory. I can't tell you whether he purchased these images somewhere and just put them together. I don't know any of that. I just know that I love them. I totally love them. They just, oh, look at this. They just really, really speak to me. And I knew I needed to make something out of them. Just had to. Okay, and then here are the bookmarks. Aren't those gorgeous? I printed on HP, oh goodness, where is it? Hammermill cardstock. I wanted my Epson presentation paper because it prints a truer. This has more golden tones to it, and it's the paper. I know with my Echo Tank, it's touchy with the papers, and I was out of the presentation paper, so this is what I got, and the prints are still vibrant and beautiful. But just be aware that depending on what your printer is and what your paper is, you may get different tones on yours than what I have here. Whatever you get is going to be absolutely gorgeous. And I'll show you here in a minute. Okay, here's some more. Here's tags. And now, you're not limited to, you can make these bigger or smaller or whatever you want by how, what you choose on your printer to make them. So pretty. So if I do a journal, I would have, like, this would be a gorgeous little belly band. And I did cut out one of these, and I don't know, it should be right here. I cut it out last night, but you know, I might have left it sitting downstairs. I bet I did. Okay, let me show you this. I printed these, and I was trying to get my printer to print right. I had a little clog in it, so that did it. So my colors weren't true, and I was trying different settings and different papers. And you can see, look how muted and whatever that is. And then I thought there was one here. Yeah, this one. This one is just thin paper. So what I did was I have... Oh, where are they? Where are they? I also printed background papers, and I'll have to list these down below. I had him send me the links for several different sets of background papers, just plain. Look at this. But these will go gorgeous. Well, let me show you. It'll just take a second. Just bear with me here. I wasn't prepared. Oh, here it is, right here. Now look at here. If I take these and I take these and I fold this, and this is the inside of my card, this is the outside of my card, so when I open it, this is the inside with the sentiment on it. And I'll show you one that I did that way. That is so simple, people. This is cardstock, so this is a great weight for the base of my card. And then I just need to add my sentiment to it, cut it to the size I want, trim this down so it fits either full on my 5x7 cards or however I want. I don't remember the names of these. I'm so sorry. But I will list them down below with the links. But these, I think there's four different ones that I had him send me. Oh, this is the one that I used right here on the card that I'm going to show you. Absolutely gorgeous. But I wanted something that was solids or something that I could use, look at his, for the inside of my card. So just let me show you here what I have and what I've done. I took this image, and then I took that one with the flower. Okay, I printed this all out. I don't know if I've got it right here again or not, where it went to. Where are you? Where are you? But here it is. Okay, I printed it just like this. Printed it out. I cut it to 10 inches across by 7 inches high. That's what I have, 10 by 7. I scored it in the middle. This is the inside of my card. So I folded it. I didn't print on the back. I folded it so the white was on the outside. And then I had these goober pages that I was testing my ink. And one of them was just, like I told you, where is it? find anything when I want it. It was just the lightweight copy paper, and of course I'm not finding it. It was right here a minute ago, and now it's gone. But it was a lightweight copy paper. Oh, it's here, I think. I don't know. It was a lightweight copy paper, and I had printed it, so I glued that piece here, like to the back of that. And it was a whole piece. I glued it to the back. Then I took this piece and cut it down so it's not 4x6, but it's smaller to fit in here. I popped it on some foam tape, and this is my card. And I just sat here and stared at it because it's absolutely lovely. So I'm going to go off and I'm going to play with this and the background papers, and I will come back and share with you what I've made. But in the meantime, I'm going to give you the links to his store, the links to what I have gotten, and the discounts code so you can go look, and maybe there'll be something that you will want to try out. So until next time, check out the Etsy store. Bontik Vintage Designs journal. This is the journal kit. Little Chapel is what I've got here, and it's a 50% discount off the whole store, and the code is just my name, Patty. So until I see you next time, have a great crafty day. I have another video that's already been uploaded and done and ready, but I can't show you yet because it's a gift for my daughter and her birthday is Sunday. I'm just afraid the little stinker will look at it, and I don't want her to be not surprised by what I give her. So as soon as Sunday comes, I'll be turning that video live too. So have a great crafty day, everybody. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll be back with some more lovely cards and ideas. Oh, I am in love with this kit. Okay, until next time. Bye-bye now.